do a video. I wanted to talk a little bit about what to expect when you go through a weigh station and what to expect when you get pulled in or pulled over for a DOT inspection. That's one of the things, again, I had no clue about when we started in expediting. You know, I had never driven a commercial vehicle, so I had never pulled in through a weigh station or been through a DOT inspection. So I kind of wanted to do a video just to talk a little bit about it, maybe help some of you who are, again, just getting into this or thinking about getting into this, expediting or trucking, and what to expect when you get pulled in for a DOT inspection and when you have to go in through a weigh station. So hopefully this will help some of y'all. So I want to talk about first about what is a weigh station. Even if you've never driven a commercial vehicle, I'm sure you've all seen the weigh station signs on interstates. Every state has them. What it is it's an inspection station where the state can pull you in as a commercial vehicle and inspect your vehicle. It just protects them. They check your weight, make sure you're not operating overweight for the specifications of the type of vehicle that you're driving, and to make sure that there's no unsafe vehicles out there on their highway. So as a commercial vehicle driver, you can be pulled in at any time into these weigh stations if they're open. Like I said before, when we first started driving, I didn't know what to expect. Most of the weigh stations, depending on the state, are pretty much all the same. You're going to, if you get pulled in, you're going to either have a bypass lane or a lane where they're going to weigh you. Some don't have a bypass lane, some weigh you. So basically, when you pull into the weigh station, you want to pay attention to the signs, pay attention to the instructions that are posted for you. If you don't get a bypass arrow and you have to go over the scale, some scales you just roll over and they weigh, some you have to actually have to stop on the scale. They're all different. You just, like I said, have to pay attention to the signs and the lights to see what you need to do. First thing, when you roll into a weigh station, you need to roll down your window. Most all weigh stations are going to have an intercom, and the officer may be telling you directions over the intercom, and you want to hear what they're saying. If you have your windows up, you're not going to be able to hear what they're saying. So that's the first thing you really want to do when you start pulling into a weigh station and have to go over a scale. Even before you get a bypass light, sometimes there'll be an intercom where they can talk to you and give you direction. There's some states where they have, they're called port of entries. And what that is, for instance, Arizona, New Mexico, Wyoming, those particular weigh stations, they're checking to make sure your paperwork is in order. Sometimes they'll have a window and they'll want to see your registration, your IFTA paperwork, permits to drive in their state. Some others, you have to go into the weigh station. They'll want you to bring in your permit book so they can see your paperwork for your truck, your bill of lading. California, they have inspection stations where when you enter into California, and if you're loaded, they want to see your bill of lading to make sure, you know, you don't have any agriculture or produce, things like that. Those inspection stations in California are normally separate from the weigh station. Same thing in Florida, they have those as well. So again, if you get pulled into the weigh station, you want to pay attention to the signs. If you get weighed, you go over the scale, pay attention. They're either going to pass you to go on ahead and get back on the freeway, or they may pull you in for an inspection. If they do, there's either going to be a sign or they're going to tell you over the intercom, pull around to the bay for inspection. Now, one thing before I start talking about inspections, I want to talk about with the weigh stations. You can get what's called a PrePass. All you have to do is call them up. They have a website and a phone number, and you can get that. Some owners provide that for you. Jason and I, we didn't get ours until after probably we were doing this for 2 years before we finally got that. And mainly, first of all, we didn't know how much it was. We thought it was way more expensive than what it was. But actually, I wish we would have got it a lot sooner, because it definitely saves a lot of time. What the PrePass is, basically, it's an electronic device that you put in the windshield. When you register for it, you give them all the truck information, all your billing information, things like that. And basically what it does, some of these way stations have PrePass sites. And what it does is it has a sensor that when you roll over, it scans your PrePass and gives them all the information, and it also weighs you. So with that PrePass, you can either get a green light where you don't have to go through that scale even if it's open, or you'll get a red light where you still have to go into the scale. But I can't tell you how many times that we've been able to bypass scales because we've got green lighted and hadn't had to waste time pulling into the scales, slow down, speed back up to get back on the freeway, saves you time for possibly not getting inspected and wasting time with that. You know, if you're on a deadline and you're trying to get somewhere, going through way stations and the possibility of being inspection, that's going to slow you down. Especially some of these way stations can get pretty full, like in California, and it takes you 5 minutes just to get through the line to get onto the scale. So the PrePass, I'm not sure if the price is different depending on what type of vehicle you're driving. For us, we pay, it's $14.90 a month. Again, that is an expense that you can write off on your taxes. That price that we get is actually a little bit of a discounted price because we're members of OOIDA, which is a trucking owner operator organization, to where if you join them, you get discounts on certain things. I'll talk about them in another video when we talk about some different memberships that are good to have. Or I'll leave a link in the description box below to the PrePass website so you can kind of look at that. Like I said, if you drive for an owner or a company, some of those owners and companies supply those for you. You can also link up I think it's called an Easy Pass, where it works on some of the toll booths, like in the Northeast, up North Ohio, things like that. We don't have the Easy Pass yet. We just haven't linked that to it or got that. But that's also a good tool and saves you time from having to stop and pay cash for the tolls. So I want to talk a little bit about DOT inspections. That was another thing, I had no clue what to expect. I'd read about DOT inspections and what they were, but until you're actually pulled in for one or pulled over for one, you really don't know what to expect. So that's why I wanted to kind of talk about that. In the 3 years we've been doing this, we've been inspected. I can probably count on one hand the times we've been inspected. I know there's some drivers, they get inspected, it seems like every other month. Some drivers, it could be once a year. So it's just all depends on, the luck of the draw, I guess, if you get pulled in for an inspection. Like I said, you can get inspected in a way station, or a state trooper can also pull you over on the interstate and do an inspection. Just because you don't go through a way station, that doesn't mean that you can't be pulled over by a state trooper to be inspected. I know twice I've been pulled over by a officer to get inspected, and then another couple times we hadn't been inspected through the way stations. So they can pull you over to do an inspection if they so choose to. So with the DOT inspections, there's technically 6 levels of inspections that they can do. We've only had level 1 and level 2 inspections, so those are really the only ones I can really talk about and our experience with that. That's another link I'll leave down in the description box that tells you about the different levels of inspection and what they do on those levels of inspection. So you can kind of read that yourself and see what those inspections entail. So, like I said, we've only been pulled in or pulled over for a level 1 and level 2 inspection. So with those inspections, a level 1 inspection, that inspection is pretty much, they're going to look at everything. They're going to check stuff with your truck. They're going to check your lights, your horn. They're going to check your brakes. They're going to go under the truck, check some things under there, your tires, horn, all of the basic things that you should be inspecting when you do your pre-trip every day. They're not only are they going to check the vehicle, but they're also going to check your credentials. They're going to want to see your CDL. They're going to want to see your medical card. Now, I have heard somebody was telling me that with the medical cards, a lot of those are going onto the computer. So I know the last inspection I had in New Mexico, he didn't need to see my medical card because I'm assuming he brought that up online. So, but they can ask you for that. They can ask you for your paperwork for your load. They can ask you for your logs. You know, if you have electronic logs, they're going to want to see your logs, or they're going to want to see your log book to check your hours of service. If you're loaded, they can have you open up the back and check your load. We do a lot of loads that sometimes are sealed, so a lot of times they may not have you open it up, because if they do, they have to provide you with a comparable seal to seal up that load. So, but if it's not sealed, and even if it is sealed, they can still open that up and look in your load, especially, you know, if you're hauling hazmat. One of the first inspections I got, we were hauling flammable hazmat, and, you know, he wanted to check our load, make sure that load was secured properly for the hazmat. So they can check all of that in a level 1 inspection. That's pretty much the Mac Daddy of inspections. They're going to look at everything. Now, a level 2 inspection, most of the time with a level 2 inspection, they're just kind of checking basic things, a basic walk around the truck, pretty much everything except for getting under the truck to look at the things they look under there, your air brakes, things like that, that they get under there for oil leaks, you know, but they'll still probably ask you for your CDL. And all your paperwork if you're loaded. So when you get pulled in or pulled over for an inspection, you want to listen to the officer's direction. They're going to tell you exactly what you wanted, what they want you to do. We've heard a lot of people, you know, horror stories of people get pulled in for an inspection and the officers are just so very rude to them and very short, and, you know, they're just looking for something to give them a violation on. You know, in our experience, and like I said, I can probably count on one hand the inspections we've got in 3 years, and we've probably been fortunate. But, you know, if an officer comes up and he seems in a bad mood or rude, I've always found that, you know, you just be nice and polite, and 9 times out of 10, that's going to change his attitude. Maybe he's having a bad day. You know, if he comes up to you and is short and kind of has that attitude, you know, just keep calm and don't be rude back, because that's just going to escalate a situation, and you don't want to make them mad to where they're looking for violations to give you. So, you know, the one situation, you know, I had when one of the officers pulled me over for an inspection the first time for a level 2 inspection, you know, he he was behind me. I didn't see he had his lights on until he got over into the passing lane. And when he did, I saw him. And then, of course, once I did, I immediately pulled over. When he came up to the window, you know, he kind of had an attitude and was saying, well, you don't check your mirrors much, you know, you didn't see me back there. And I'm like, well, no, sir, I do check my mirrors. I just didn't see you right behind my vehicle until you got over in the passing lane, and then I saw your lights, you know. And I just was very respectful and nice and, you know, apologized. And once I did that, you know, he was very nice and he changed his attitude. So, you know, just keep that in mind. You know, even if you're having a bad day, you do not want to make those officers mad or give them any reason to be looking for something to give you a violation on your truck, because that not only hurts, you know, your score on your CDL, but it hurts your company's CSA score. And you know, you don't want that, especially for something so trivial, just of over having a bad attitude with the officer. Once the officer has completed the inspection, he's gonna put everything, his findings, into a computer. If he does find any violations, he's gonna let you know what those are, and he's gonna list them on the inspection sheet. Once he's done with everything, he is going to give you an inspection sheet. He's going to have you sign it. Like I said, he's going to tell you if you passed, if you had any violations. If there are violations, you know, depending on the violations, they can either shut you down where you cannot move until that particular thing is fixed. Or it could be as little as an oil leak that they just say, you know, you need to fix it and then provide us with the paperwork once that repair is done. So once they give you that paperwork, again, they're going to explain everything to you. They're going to have you sign it, and then they're going to give you a copy, and they keep a copy. You want to, with us, you know, when we get inspected, we need to, we forward that to Panther's safety department, so that they can keep a copy on file. And also, you know, they're required, if there is a violation, that, you know, they're gonna make sure that whatever that violation is fixed, and then the proper paperwork showing that that was fixed is sent to the state of who gave you the violations, or the DOT inspection, the state you had the inspection in, so that that can be cleared. You know, obviously the goal of any inspection is to get a passing inspection. You don't want any violations. You know, even with the best pre-trips, you know, there is a possibility that you can get a violation. You know, one of the inspections we had when we were in the truck before this one, it had an oil leak, but it wasn't leaking at the time we had the inspection. It basically, on the bottom of the engine, it had a lot of oil residue still left on the engine. So when the officer went under the truck to look at that, you know, he saw all that oil and automatically assumed that we had an oil leak at that time. So, you know, basically, you know, you don't want to argue with the officer. Yes, sir, you know, just take whatever they say, and do the proper things you need to do to remedy the situation. In that situation, basically what we had to do, you know, we took the truck to Blue Beacon and had them do a real thorough wash of the undercarriage and the engine. So, yeah, and once we did that, you know, we sent Panther, you know, the receipt for that, and to show them that we took care of that violation. So again, with the DOT inspection, the main thing is just listen to what the officer tells you. He's going to let you know what he wants you to do, and just follow his direction. That's all you have to do. And if you're doing your proper pre-trips every day, checking everything you need to be checking on your pre-trips, you shouldn't have anything to worry about when you get pulled in for an inspection. I just wanted to kind of talk about it a little bit, because I know when I first was pulled in for my first inspection, you know, I was nervous because I'd never done it before, didn't know what to expect. So, that's why I wanted to talk about that. And again, talking about, you know, a little bit about the weigh stations. Same thing with those. Just follow the instructions, follow the signs. It's going to tell you what to do, and you'll be good. So I hope that helps, you know, ease anybody's mind of what to expect if you've never been through a weigh station or even been in, you know, you may just gotten out into doing this and have not had an inspection yet. So hopefully that helped a little bit. If you had any questions or concerns about those two things. So again, I'll leave a couple links in the description box below. I'll leave the link about the different levels of inspections and what those entail. And then I'll also leave the link to the PrePass site so you can take a look at that if you're interested in getting that for your truck. If y'all have any questions about inspections or going through weigh stations, you know, you can always comment down below, send us an email, send us a message on Facebook. I'll be happy to answer any questions that I can. You know, if it's something that I don't know 100% about, I can at least direct you, find out the information myself for you, or direct you where you can get more information. You know, again, the EO website, Expediters Online, has a lot of great information for expediters. The forums, you know, if you just get on there and scroll through, there's a ton of topics on there, and I'm sure there's one that probably talks about DOT inspections and weigh stations as well. So that's a really good resource for a lot of things and a lot of questions you may have on expediting too. Also, you know, if there's a particular topic that you want us to do a video on, let us know. You know, we love hearing your suggestions and your feedback on our videos, and, you know, want to know if there's something you would like us to do a video on in particular, just let us know. And if we can, we'll do a video on that for you. So hope this helped give you a little bit more information on some things you need to know. And we will see you in the next video. Take care.